Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video where we are going to be evaluating this integral from the 2024, so this past year's, integration B. And without any more further ado, let's jump straight into it. The first thing we're going to do is actually a sort of simple u sub. So we are going to let u equal e to the x minus 1. And this allows us to do a couple of things. First off, it allows us to express this denominator as literally just u, but also it allows us to express what's inside the natural log here as 2u plus 1. So now it's a natural log of 2u plus 1 divided by u. And then now we just need to take care of the du thing. So du equals e to the x dx, but e to the x is just going to be u plus 1. So now we just have natural log of all that divided by u, and then a u plus 1 right here. Then, of course, our bounds are actually not going to change because, well, e to the 0 is just 1 still, 1 minus 1 is 0, and in the infinity bit stays the same. So now with this integral, what we're going to do is apply Feynman's technique. And we're going to apply it right here where this 2 is, replacing it with just a more general t right there. And what we're going to do is then differentiate with respect to t. And doing this actually gives us something quite interesting. We now have still an integral, of course, but it's the integral from 0 to infinity of, 1 over u plus 1 times 2u plus 1, or pardon me, tu, or ut, if you will, if you're a fan, plus 1. And then by the chain rule, the u right here in the denominator is going to cancel with the extra u we get from differentiating. So right here, we are just going to add the du. And this is where things start to get a little bit interesting. We can actually evaluate this integral by partial fractions, something you would learn in BC, actually. That'd be cool if I should ask if I can put this on their test. That'd be interesting. Anyways. So what we're going to say is we have 1 over u plus 1 times ut plus 1. I try to curve my t's so that way they don't look like plus signs. I have had to adjust my handwriting because of math. Such is the life of a math person with awful handwriting. Anyway, before I start yapping about that even more, we have a over u plus 1 plus b over, I'm going to start writing this as tu, actually, just because, so you don't get confused with the plus sign. And then we have this, and of course, we're just going to cross multiply now. So we have a times tu plus 1 plus b times u plus 1. And that all right there is equal to 1. And solving for a and b really isn't too awful. You just plug in u equals negative 1, and we end up getting a, and then times 1 minus t equals 1. So a is just going to be equal to 1 over 1 minus t. And then our b is going to be equal to, a similar thing. We're just going to let u equal 1 over negative 1 over t. So then we have 1 over 1 minus 1 over t, which is a little bit not nice to look at. So what I'm going to do, and you'll see why I'm doing this in a little bit, is just say this is negative t over 1 minus t right here. So now what we can express this integral as is the following integral from 0 to infinity, but then we have this a, so 1 over t, or 1 minus 1 over t. So that's our a, and then 1 over 1 plus u. And then I'm going to say minus r, or plus rb, but it's a minus t over 1 minus t. I'm just doing this so that we can eventually factor things out. And then inside here, we are going to have a 1 plus tu plus 1 du. And integration actually really isn't too awful. I'm going to factor out the factor of 1 over 1 minus t real fast. And what we find is, no integral, we can just kind of go straight into the antiderivative. We have natural log of 1 plus u right here. That should be relatively clear. And we have minus the natural log of tu plus 1. And based on the bounds of our integral, we have to evaluate this whole expression right here from infinity or from infinity to zero, or zero to infinity, however you like to say it, in that order, that I wrote. And to do that, you might say initially, well, oh, well, both of those diverge. But when we combine them using properties of logs, what we find is it actually does converge to some sort of value. So we have 1 over 1 minus t. And then we have natural log of, well, u plus 1, and then divided by t u plus 1. Still evaluated from 0 to infinity. And you'll note here that whenever we plug in 0, the whole expression actually is just 0 because we have natural log of 1 because, you know, everything with the u goes away. But if we plug in infinity, if you take the limit here, it actually just becomes natural log of 1 over t, meaning that you bring down the negative sign for the log. We actually have natural log of t divided by t minus 1. And this is the part where it gets a little bit interesting, because we've now converted our original integral up here to this expression here, but what we had done was Feynman's technique right here, meaning that we actually need to integrate this new function. We need to integrate this now from 0, not from 0 to 1, but actually from 0 to 2. The reason there being that in the original integral, we had a 2 right there. Thank you, OneNote, for lagging. So now we just need to evaluate this right here, natural log of t over t minus 1 dt. So now to evaluate this, what we're actually going to do is split this up into two integrals. The first one being from 0 to 1, so we have the integral of 0 to 1 of natural log of t over t minus 1 dt. And as you might expect, we're going to evaluate the integral from 2 to 1, or 1 to 2, of the natural log of t over t minus 1. The bounds here, well, the bounds for this one are actually nice. Bounds for here are a little bit mean, but, I mean, those will get sorted out quite nicely in a little bit. So let's get evaluating, shall we? What we're actually going to do here is a little bit ironic. We're going to apply Feynman's technique again, insert, jazz hands here. We're going to say that this is now, the integral from 0 to 1, but we have, t to some, I need to think this through, because I usually use t as for Feynman's technique, t to some alpha, I suppose, over t minus 1 dt. Goodness, I'm not used to using something other than t. I guess alpha works. I wouldn't use k either, because that's, I use that for, summation things. Or as a summation index, that's what it's called. Anyway, back to the math. To evaluate this, then, we're actually going to express the denominator as a geometric series. So what we're going to say, then, is 1 over t minus 1. Well, this is equal to just negative 1 over 1 minus t. And because of our interval right here is from 0 to 1, we know we can just express this actually as the sum from k equals 0 to infinity of t to the k. So in doing so, in switching this order of integral and sum, we find that we have negative sum of our integral from 0 to 1 of t to then some alpha plus k, and then dt. And the integral of this, that's really not too awful. It's just, power rule, but reverse. So this right here is actually equal to the negative sum from k equals 0 to infinity of 1 over alpha plus k plus 1. But we are not done yet because, again, we applied Feynman's technique. But this time, instead of actually integrating, we have to differentiate because we integrated essentially before. So now we have to differentiate, meaning that we need to apply the derivative to all this. So d over d alpha of 1 over alpha plus 1 k plus 1. Well, this right here isn't too awful. It's literally just going to be negative 1 over alpha plus k plus 1, but then squared. Meaning a couple of things. First and foremost, that these pesky negatives, these actually cancel. Yay! Leaving us with the sum from k equals 0 to infinity of 1 over, well, alpha. But what exactly was alpha to begin with? Alpha right here was 0 because, well, The implied t term right here is, well, to the 0 power. So really we have 0 there, so it's just k plus 1 squared. And that's a very well-known sum. You know, if you just re-index this to just k equals 1 to infinity of 1 over k squared, this right here, well, kind of a little bit of a famous math thing right here. That's just pi squared over 6. I do technically have other videos sort of deriving that, I think, but anyways, I digress. So we've actually evaluated one of these integrals now. Time to go back to the other. And this one right here, we're going to do something kind of similar. We're going to let u equal t minus 1 right here. And that is going to get our bounds to something a little bit nicer, actually. So now we have the du dt, same thing really, integral from 0 to 1. Now we have natural log of t plus 1, or pardon me, really u plus 1. It doesn't really matter, but I'll be consistent. People get on me when I'm not. And the way we're going to do this one right here is actually just going to express natural log as a series. So we're going to say natural log of, I should write this in a different color because I have those. Natural log of u plus 1, we can say or express on this interval from 0 to 1 as the sum from k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k minus 1 over k, but then times u to the k as well. So what we have, replacing everything, is the following sum from k equals 1 to infinity, negative 1 to the k minus 1 over k. And then integral from 0 to 1 of just u to the k minus 1 du. And that integral right there, well, that's really not awful to evaluate at all. Because that right there is just going to be u to the k, and then we have a factor of 1 over k here, evaluated from 0 to 1, which is just 1 over k. Meaning that this whole thing right here is actually just a sum from k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k minus 1 over k squared, which you might recognize as eta of 2. Or if you were to evaluate this using a couple of identities and or other fun techniques, you end up finding this is actually pi squared over 12. So now we have our two things, right, two bits right here. We have a pi squared over 6, and we have a pi squared over 12. And in order to find the value of our integral, we just need to add them up. So what happens when we smush these two values together? Well, we have pi squared over 6 plus pi squared over 12. Let's see if I can do basic arithmetic. That's always a good challenge. It's going to be 3 over 12 pi squared, which is just going to be pi squared over 4. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is our answer to that awesome MIT integration B. Some of the finals, actually. Integral. Thank you all so much for watching and your patience, especially for you know, me not uploading for a little while. Anyway, I'll keep it short enough. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.